If you're like me and you own a 20 plus year old car, then you probably know about cracked dashes. And if you own a car from the 90s and your dash isn't cracked, who are you? Now, cracked dashes can be as minor as a few small blemishes, or it could be completely destroyed, like mine. Fortunately for me, the junkyard had a spare dash they didn't mind letting me pay them for. Unfortunately for me, that new one that I bought was still sh** and cracked into a million pieces. But this video isn't about all the fiberglass work I had to do to get my dash looking halfway decent. It's about turning my Frankenstein's monster looking job into something that looks good. So I did what I presume any car enthusiast on a budget would do. I went to Amazon for help. Now I'm sure most of you know what flocking is, but for those of you who don't, it's basically these real fine fibers that used to be used to coat the dashboards of race cars to reduce the glare in their windshields. But I'm just gonna be using it to make my dash look a little bit nicer. The kit comes with a 3-ounce bag of fibers which is said to cover up to 15 square feet, a container of adhesive, the applicator, and a brush. The kit I purchased was like $40 on Amazon, but you could find different kits anywhere for different prices, and they all basically do the same thing. Now, I've never actually done this before, so it's gonna be a learning experience for me too, but I have seen a ton of YouTube videos, and that pretty much makes me qualified. The process is pretty straightforward from beginning to end. The first thing you're gonna wanna do is remove the dash from your car. This is gonna be the hardest and longest part of the entire job, and it might make you question your entire life, but you gotta do it, so. Now, after you have the dash removed in place where you're gonna work, next step is to clean it. So you're gonna wanna take some acetone and a clean microfiber and just give it a good wipe down. Now after you have the dash cleaned, you're gonna wanna sand it. I don't know what grit I'm gonna use yet, but it really shouldn't matter as long as you give it a good scuffing. And after it's sanded, you're gonna wanna clean it again. Just do the same thing. Now that you have the dash out, cleaned, sanded, and cleaned again, you're ready to start laying your adhesive. You can either use a paintbrush that comes with the kit, or you can get a small roller if you want to speed up the process. And after the adhesive is laid, you're ready to start spraying your flock. So just fill up your gun and just start pumping. I'm going to be starting with this smaller piece just in case I mess something up, since I don't really know what I'm doing. At least I won't be messing up the whole dash. I'll just be messing up this small cover. First things first, clean. Put a little bit of acetone on your cloth. My cloth isn't really that clean, but you know. I put this plastic down here to try to catch some of the extra fibers that fall down, just because I'm worried that that bag might not be enough to cover the entire thing.
It was at this moment that he knew he fucked up.
Oh, so once you put the adhesive on, you only have about 15 minutes before it's completely dry. So you kind of have to lay it on fast, and then you have to quickly put the flock on so that it'll stick. All right, well, I think it's pretty much covered. All right, I guess we just... This is much more of a workout than I was expecting. This is all that I have left. It'll cover it, but I don't know if it's gonna look that good. finished. However, as you can see, it's very patchy, unfortunately, because I didn't have enough fiber. Well, not to my surprise, it came out like shit. The 3-ounce bag of fibers was simply not enough to cover the entire dashboard, and the plastic I laid down to help catch the excess fibers that didn't stick didn't help whatsoever due to how windy it was outside. Now, I could have called it a day and had a semi-flock dash and it would have been whatever, but I didn't want to do that. So I went back on Amazon, bought a new bag of fibers, a new can of adhesive, and I went outside and I redid the entire thing. And this is how it turned out. Just finished getting the dash put in and I think it came out great. Did I spend more than I originally planned to? Yeah, but that's okay because I wanted it to be done correctly. Now, if you're gonna do this yourself, then I suggest not doing it when it's windy outside and putting down some plastic to help catch anything that doesn't stick. Or just buy some more material up front to be safe. If you made it this far, then thank you for putting up with me. Hopefully this came out halfway decent. And if you want to keep up with the project, the next week I'll be throwing on some lowering springs and dropping the car a couple inches. So make sure you're subscribed with notifications on so you don't miss out. Peace. So freaking hot!